you have all the advantage. Of the two of us, you and I, who is the greater coward? He asked seriously. If the situation is unpleasing, you compromise with your conscience when you make yourself a party to it. If you were really great, really true to yourself, you would join forces with Leech and Johnson. But you are afraid. You are afraid. You want to live. The life that is in you cries out that it must live no matter what the cost. So you live ignominiously, untrue to the best you dream of, sinning against your whole pitiful little code, and, if there were a hell, heading your soul straight for it. Bah! I play the braver part. I do no sin, for I am true to the promptings of the life that is in me. I am sincere with my soul, at least, and that is what you are not.
There was a sting in what he said. Perhaps, after all, I was playing a cowardly part. And the more I thought about it, the more it appeared that my duty to myself lay in doing what he had advised, lay in joining forces with Johnson and Leech and working for his death. Right here, I think, entered the austere conscience of my Puritan ancestry, impelling me toward lurid deeds, and sanctioning even murder as right conduct. I dwelt upon the idea. It would be a most moral act to rid the world of such a monster. Humanity would be better and happier for it, life fairer and sweeter. I pondered it long, lying sleepless in my bunk, and reviewing in endless procession the facts of the situation. I talked with Johnson and Leech during the night watches, when Wolf Larsen was below. Both men had lost hope. Johnson, because of temperamental despondency. Leech, because he had beaten himself out of the vain struggle and was exhausted. But he caught my hand in a passionate grip